I am being faced with the greatest challenge known to song explainers, and that is I Am the Walrus by the Beatles. Hey everybody, I'm Clifford Stummy, the pop song professor. Welcome to my channel where we make English class awesome by explaining and sometimes roasting song lyrics on weekdays. Today we are talking about I Am the Walrus by the Beatles, and this song is actually suggested by my patrons. By the way, my Patreon link down below, super inexpensive. You get to choose songs for me to explain. It's a really great community, and we chat all the time. We're like total bros, but I digress. My patrons nominated this song for me to roast it, and I'm a little bit confused because I started researching the song and the deeper meanings of it, and there's actually a really cool story behind it. So in this video, I am going to explain what this song means and where it comes from, but in honor of my patrons, I'm going to do something that would be very much in the spirit of what John Lennon foresaw for this song. And I, as an English teacher, am going to try to just explain it off the top of my head before I explain to you what it actually means. I'm gonna read some lyrics, try to interpret them. You can judge whether I do it well or not, and then we'll see exactly what John Lennon thinks of that in a second. All right, here, let's go for it. All right, I am he, as you are me, and we are all together. Sounds like a group, a community, people in connection with each other. See how they run like pigs from a gun. See how they fly on crime. Sometimes pigs is slang for the police, so it could be like gang warfare, but they also fly, but it could be like more like a British, like we fly away. Sitting on a cornflake, waiting for the van to come. Corporation t-shirt, stupid bloody Tuesday. People make fun of Monday, so I mean, it's a corporation, so maybe they're all at work and sitting on a cornflake is them feeling small as they wait for like the van or the bus to come take them to work. Man, you've been a naughty boy, you let your face grow long. So we shouldn't be sad about it. I feel like I'm doing a pretty good job so far. Then we get into the chorus. I am the Eggman, they are the Eggmen. I am the Walrus, goo goo gajoob. Well, okay, so I actually know that the Walrus is based on Lewis Carroll's poem about the walrus and the clams and the carpenter and everybody. And it's like a satire on capitalism apparently, so it kind of fits in with what we've been saying. Maybe the Eggmen are like the suits or the people who kind of force this corporate world on us. Mr. City, policeman sitting, pretty little policemen in a row. See how they fly like Lucy in the sky, see how they run. Lucy in the sky, like with diamonds, is like probably a drug trip. So, I mean, that could be something. Yellow matter custard dripping from a dead dog's eye. That's probably the rot of civilization. I don't know. Crabble locker fishwife, pornographic priestess. So it's like the hypocrisy and the insincerity in society. Boy, you've been a naughty girl. You let your knickers down. Not even gonna go there. I don't even know. Sitting in an English garden waiting for the sun. If the sun don't come, you get a tan from standing in the English rain. And that's just irony, and I don't know. Expert textbert, choking smokers. Don't you think the Joker laughs at you? See how they smile like pigs in a sty? See how they snide? I'm crying. All right, there's more. But I think the point is I can come up with some BS explanation of it, but there's absolutely no support for it, and it just goes off the rails. As soon as you think it means one thing, all of a sudden you're reading about being in an English garden while the English rains tan you, and we get into the Eiffel Tower and elementary penguins singing Hare Krishna. Man, you should have seen them kicking Edgar Allan Poe. Like, I gotta tell you, on one hand, this is an English teacher's dream because it feels like there's so much to dive into. But on the other hand, it's a freaking nightmare. All right, so I feel like I've acquitted myself well. I gave it a Boy Scout try. I tried to be the English teacher who could explain it. Let's talk about what I Am the Walrus actually means. Drum roll, please. It means nothing, except for in some small parts where there's like a line or two that means something here or there. And that's basically the whole point, because John Lennon was emailing some kid who was going to school, and he was saying that his English teachers were analyzing Beatles lyrics in class. So if your high school or middle school English teacher has tried to get you to analyze hip-hop lyrics to make English literature fun and cool, your teacher's actually kind of cool. At least know that they're not the first ones to think of this. This has been going on for a while. And I think artists, when they hear people doing stuff like that, kind of feel a little bit like, that's weird. I feel like these are my deep personal thoughts. Why are other people analyzing them with logic? And maybe they feel a little bit violated. In any case, John Lennon thought that it was funny, and so what he did is he set out to write a song that nobody could explain. And working with his friend Pete Shotton to write the song, he said kind of sarcastically, "Let the effers work that out." And so the whole point of the song was kind of to just be sort of a middle finger to English teachers and song explainers. That's you and me, guys. The song originally started as three different songs and pulled a lot of little pieces or references from other things, so it's kind of a hodgepodge. The part about Mr. City Policeman kind of was inspired by the sound of a siren in London. The second part where he's singing about being in an English garden was about him actually sitting in an English garden. And the third was a short nonsense poem about sitting on a cornflake, and all of these things got mished and mashed into the larger song. The Walrus does refer to Lewis Carroll's poem The Walrus and the Carpenter. John Lennon later found out that the Walrus was actually kind of the bad guy, but he's glad that he stuck with "I am the Walrus" because it sounds better and weirder than "I am the Carpenter." And the part about yellow matter custard, green slop pie, all mixed together with a dead dog's eye, comes from a poem that he and Pete Shotton used to apparently recite or sing when they were children. Apparently the phrase "elementary penguin," which, I mean, try using that as an insult with your friends, isn't that wonderful? Ha, ha, you elementary penguin you! Or you could just keep saying what comes up in the chorus. "I am the Eggman, they are the Eggmen, I am the Walrus, goo goo gajoob, goo goo gajoob, goo goo," and what? But that line about the elementary penguin apparently does refer to people who put all of their eggs in one basket, so to speak, or people who chase the Hare Krishna or worship at the feet of just one idol. People who are obsessed with like the certain version of spiritual enlightenment. And people will try to tell you that there's a deeper meaning to this song, and they'll point to references from other Beatles songs, but these other references keep contradicting each other and talking about like who is the Walrus or whatever. And really, at the heart of it, the whole point of the song is just to be confusing, with largely no point. I highly recommend that you guys check out the music video though. It's really weird, and they have like these little like egg looking hats, and there's these policemen doing line dances, and the Beatles are all there, and it's super, super weird, and they're wearing like, one guy's wearing a walrus mask. And there's like 12 dudes in egg costumes inside of like one giant long circular piece of cloth that makes them all look like they're one egg together? I don't know. But in any case, guys, you should check out this song, at least give it a shot. I'll have a link in the description to the music video. And let me know what you think. Can you find anything within the song that means something? Or is it all the Illuminati? Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to check out these videos. Thanks for watching, guys. And thank you so much to my patrons for not only suggesting this, but for also being my patrons and being part of our community. It's so good to have you guys working with me and for you to help me put out videos like this for everybody else. Thank you, guys. You do something absolutely special here. And thank you to everybody who's watching. Don't forget to check out these videos, and I'll talk to you next time.